We are very lucky today to have some really wonderful, inspirational women with us here to share their views and their views and tips and guidance along the way. Understanding the future and the decisions you're going to be making is really important. It's really important to start thinking about that. So listen carefully to the ladies as they talk to you and be really good at asking questions and what have you. But it's not all us talking, there's lots of things for you to do as well. So I'm just going to first introduce, go through the speakers that we've got, so you've got a little bit of an understanding, and I'm sure they'll give you a little bit more background as well. First of all, we've got Ruth here. This is Ruth Ofori-Danso. Ruth graduated from Durham University in 2015, and she did a degree in sociology. And she then did her master's degree in contemporary social thought at LSE in London. That's the London School of Economics and Political Science. After university, she's worked in a variety of roles in a variety of industries, and I'm sure she'll probably tell you a little bit about them without herself. But she's founded an organisation called the Cultivate Cloud, and that cultivates the potential of young people to become well-informed and to help them make good choices. So I think she's a really good person to inspire you to be well-informed and make good choices. Once Ruth's finished, oh, actually, there's a little bit of extra in her spare time. I thought you might like this bit. Ruth, among your hobbies, you enjoy watching Marvel movies, video editing, and she loves travelling to different countries to explore new cultures. So a little bit more background. Right, if you don't really want to listen to me talking, I'm going to hand straight over to Ruth and let her take over.
Thank you so much. Good morning, girls.
Good morning.
How's everyone?
Good. Yes.
Cool. I know you've got a very exciting day ahead of you. So what we're going to do is, we're going to start an activity, and then I'll tell you about myself and about my experiences. So, the game is called Guess the Number. So there's going to be a few statistics that come up, and I want you to guess the number. There's no, well, there is right and wrong answers, but there is a right answer. If you get it right, you get one of these packs. It has loads of like notebooks, pens, and a little bit more information. So, do the first one. To make it fair, please put up your hand, and if you get it right, then I'll come over to you. So, first one. In 2017 to 2018, how many million students were studying at UK, this is in this country, higher education institutions? Does anyone want to take a guess? I'll take this to an approximate.
Yeah. 3 million.
Not three, unfortunately.
Half a million.
Not half a million?
Six.
Not six?
I'm sorry. Five?
Not five.
1.5 million.
No.
Two.
Yeah. Oh. Wait, two, three, four to be exact, because of time, I'll go for 2 million. Next one. In 2016 to 2017, what percentage of graduates were in work or further study within 6 months of leaving university? So it's going to be out of 100 because it's a percentage.
10%.
10%. Not 10%?
30%.
Not 30?
35?
Not 35, sorry.
40.
Not 40?
60.
Not 60?
37%.
Not 30, I'll take not 30. I'll give you a clue to make it a little bit easier. I'll give it to you to the closest whole percentage. Not 15?
4.
Not 4? Just think about how much homework you do a week and try and make it as realistic as
possible.
Not 30, not 10, not 12, not 8. There's been a few people who've been close, but I can't really say it's going to make it too easy.
14. Yeah. Oh my God. You work out.
Yeah. There's more opportunities to win some packs during it, but we'll get started. So, my name is Ruth Ofori-Danso. I was here last year, but obviously we weren't in that year at the time. So I'm currently 24 years of age, and in that time I've had a range of educational experiences that has been through the highs and lows, the peaks and the troughs, and all sorts of really good experiences in education and really bad experiences. And I'm also going to talk about my educational history, my employment history as well, which has been very diverse in what I've decided to do. I've tried a range of industries and I found one that I was settled in now. And in that time as well, I've also founded my own company, which is why I'm here today. So, how did it all start? So, does anyone know Renshaw High School?
Yeah.
Renshaw, yeah. So it's not too far from here. And when I finished my GCSEs, I finished with 6 A's and 5 B's, which was average for me, for not getting any stars, but I was fairly happy with the result. So I finished on a high, and I wasn't really too sure what I wanted to do and what I wanted to study for sixth form. I think it's a really big choice and kind of shapes what you're going to do at university. So I had to think really carefully what I wanted to spend my time doing. The first, I'd say, big move or big decision I made was I decided to change sixth forms, which sounds very innocent in itself, but I wanted to try something new, wanted to meet new people. But for that, I think that's maybe the first mistake I made on my educational journey. So, I went to Archbishop Innocent's. Does anybody know it?
No.
It's not as close as Greenshaw, it's in Croydon. So I went there with my 6 A's and 5 B's. I was feeling fairly confident because I think this educational thing, I think I've got it down. So I was in the shock of my life when I picked my 4 subjects. So I picked sociology, I picked economics, I picked religious studies, and I picked mathematics. So how many of you love maths? Anybody like maths? No? She's like, okay, I loved maths. I thought maths was great, it made sense, it's very logical. 2 + 2 = 4, there was no confusion to it. But I honestly say that studying maths at sixth form really humbled me. I thought I was really, really smart, but it really brought me down when I realised that it's possible to get a U. Like, I didn't even know what a U means. A U means unclassified. I've never received a U in my life, and I was like, all I see are U's in maths. And it wasn't much better for economics. I was only averaging maybe an E, and then I was also getting about maybe a C in sociology, and in religious studies I was getting a B, C. So when I finished my, at the end of my first year in sixth form, I finished with, I think, C, D, E, and a U. So how did I turn it around to go to university? When I went into the school I went into, a lot of the teachers didn't know me. They didn't know who I was, they didn't know my background, history, all they had were my grades, essentially, in front of them. So when it came to asking them questions about what I should do and what advice I should take in terms of subjects and university, they, not to their detriment, but they didn't know me enough to maybe advise me as well as they could have. When I was at Greenshaw, I'd been there for 5 years. One of my teachers who studied history, he advised me to study sociology, and as you heard earlier, that's what I went on to pursue. But before that, nobody had really known what I was interested in. So they're like, yeah, take maths seems like a good choice, take economics seems like a good choice. But those subjects were really, really difficult for me, as you can tell by my years. And more so than that, I had to also explain my grades to my parents. So my parents didn't really understand what the U was at the time, as much as I did, and they weren't really here for it, because they wanted to know how I had gone from an A to a U student. Was it the school? Was it the environment? Was it my time? And for me, I was like, I know I don't know how to study for A-levels. I realised I wasn't sure maybe how the curriculum should be run or what I should do, but that kind of motivated me to think more about what I'm going to do and how I study. So a few things I did was I started to plan my revision. So I would be very intentional about putting time aside to study. Aside from that, I also found study buddies because it actually works. Always make friends with the smartest person in the class. And if you are the smartest person in the class, teach other people, which is really helpful. And in that time, I also learned to actually study for an exam. So what does studying for an exam look like beyond past papers? Has anyone ever read the examiner's report? Examiner's report? Yeah? If you read that, that is literally the answers to the test. It's basically the examiner's going through the test last year and explaining what everyone else did wrong. If you read that, you are probably sure that you won't make the same mistakes because you've got all the answers that people made mistakes to last year. So that's something I found really of time at all when it comes to A-levels, just to warn you. So I decided that, you know what, I really want to go to university, I really, really want to do well. So how can I go from a new student to go into Durham University? 18, you want to go out? Does any of you want to go out at 18? No?
Yeah.
I wanted to go out, I wanted to go to the vibe rooms in Kingston, I wanted to be out in wherever I was, I wanted to be having a social life. But I couldn't really do that with the studying, so I knew that when I went to university, I will have that time to do everything. But still, it makes a balanced person if you do go out. So I ended up with an A star, an A and a C for my U's, and I went to study at Durham University. I realised that I really like sociology, that's what I got my A star in, and I decided that I wanted to pursue it. I didn't really know what sociology was too tough, and still when people ask me, I'm like, bit sociology. But I decided to go on and pursue a master's degree in the London School of Economics, and I'll just explain my university journey. So, as you can tell, it's a happy ending, because I actually graduated at the end of it, didn't just go there for fun. But for me, when I first went to university, I found it really difficult. I was 300 miles away from home, I'm the youngest as well, so I'm like a mom's child, and I just realised that it's quite alienating being really, really far away, and it was quite isolating as well. So I decided that if I'm going to make this work, I need to make it work for me. So I made a lot of friends when I was there, still friends that I have now, and I decided to make a little network in terms of what I wanted to do in the future. Sociology is such a diverse subject, and you can go on to ultimately anything. You can go on to, if you really wanted to, you could do a law conversion, you can go into consulting. If you really, really wanted to push it, you could probably go into accounting. But for me, I just wasn't too sure, so I decided to make some networks, join those societies, and make my time there worthwhile. I also learned what independent studying was. I'm not used to nobody giving you homework and just saying, read this, do what you want with it. And I think because I had a really tough time at sixth form, that kind of made me independent enough and I guess kind of isolated my studies to myself to give it to be my own responsibility. So because of my experience at sixth form, I decided that I learned how to study independently by studying by myself. So I went to LSE and I studied contemporary social thought. Does anybody know what contemporary social thought is? Or does anyone even want to take a guess at what it may be? There is a cat at stake, if that interests you. Any guesses? Contemporary social thought.
So if you take that sociology, what does it do about just how the people have thought about in that type of way?
I'm not too sure about the answer, but I think you can anyway. I was like, this kind of sounds like what I said, but remixed. So what contemporary social thought is, contemporary means of the time now, so it's about being commercially aware. Social is the things that are happening in regards to people, which sociology always tends to do, study people of the time, and thought is basically all the different thinkers and what they thought about it. So basically studying society as it is today. I was studying and learning things about money, I was learning things about cities, I was learning about why it was designed the way it was, I was learning about like old sociology thoughts, the likes of Durkheim and Marx and Weber, and I love all that kind of stuff, I can literally do it for days, that's what I studied. I wasn't too sure what I was going to do after, but I'll just explain two really interesting concepts I think I learned at university. So does anybody know what this is?
Bus stop.
Okay, so how many of you have been at a bus stop before? Okay, so all of us, including me. How many of you have sat on the bus stop chair? The seat? Keep your hand up if you find it comfortable. Okay. You can just shout out, why don't you find it comfortable? Does anybody know? Yes, it's cryptocurrency. It's basically, I guess you you can call it online money if you want, but it's people have attributed their value to money online and are now trading in it. So, does anybody know how much this is? £10. Are you sure? Because it's the new note. Okay, if I scrunch it up, how much is it worth now?
£10.
And when I...
Tell myself. The first one, really, things I wish I knew.
wish I knew myself. I wish I knew myself more to stay at the school I was in. Leaving at Greenshaw was one of my big regrets because I went to a school where nobody knew me. I wasn't too sure of my values either. I wasn't too sure about what I wanted to do. And I wish I really took more time to think about what do I want to pursue, and more so, why am I pursuing it? Why am I going to study this for the next 3 or 4 years? The other thing I wish I knew is, I wish I knew my books. I wish I studied more. I wish I knew my subjects. I really loved maths, and now I have a great hatred for it. Probably nightmares of all sorts. I often think about how difficult it was to do differentiation and all the other things that I try and get calculus. I wish I knew my subjects. I wish I knew it in and out. I wish I knew I studied more at the time that I could have. And you have a great opportunity because you're here into year 10. You've got GCSEs and A-levels to look forward to, and if you want, or if you decide to go to university, more so as well. And I wish I knew stuff. Like, just random stuff, general knowledge, pub, quiz knowledge, just random things. I wish I listened to podcasts. I wish I listened to more books. I wish I met more people. I wish I networked better. I wish I did so much more with this time. And if anyone's read Meg J's Defining Decade, she talks about how to make the most of your time now. And I didn't do that. I'm doing it at 24. We have the opportunity to do that in year 10. That's a much more better opportunity than someone could offer. So, the three S's, self, studies and stuff. So those are the three things I wish I knew. So I think we have some time for questions. So if you ask a question, you get a pack. So don't feel shy because I'm very chatty if you haven't realised already. And feel free to ask away. So any questions?
When did you realise that you were making a mistake?
I think it's when I started seeing the low grades because I thought it was a school to university. I didn't really think of it as in myself as an issue. But I also feel like maybe because the teachers don't know me, they didn't give me maybe not special attention. You know, sometimes you have a teacher who really likes you and will take that time to invest and spend that time with you. Teachers are like a hidden resource, I feel like. They've done this so many times. They have the time to study the questions, so they know more so and also know your abilities. But I didn't have that. I think when I started seeing my results from my in that school and the grades I was getting from that grade, I think that's where the issues were. Thank you. I'll try and do one from each side at the back.
Did you ever think about going back to your original school after seeing your grades?
I did think about it, but by the time I realised it was way too late and I'd have to redo the year because of different services and stuff, but I wanted to make the best of the situation I was in at that time, so I decided to stay. Thank you for asking. So I would have dropped maths, definitely, like there's no doubt about that. And then you picked up politics. So the politics, economics, sociology, RS, even though they're all written based, I feel like they would have complemented each other much more. And I probably would have ended up in the civil service and managed that as well. But I think I still would have studied sociology at university. But something I didn't mention is I always tried to pick up a different module. So when I was at Durham, I picked up sign language, so British Sign Language, and I also picked up social policy, and I picked it up again at LSE. Thank you for asking.
What's your favourite part of your job?
So I work at PA Consulting in business support. I'm aiming to go into an analyst role next year. I feel like PA Consulting, everybody is very, very nice. I can't like stress how nice everybody is. And I've never worked in a workplace there where people are so nice. I think because recruitment is so tough and you have to meet sales, whereas with PA Consulting, in the public sector, we're generally looking for the best for people. So we're trying to think, how can we better people, for example, when they're travelling, how can we make it quicker or easier, which I really enjoy. I'm going to try and do one each side.
Is there anything you've changed apart from schools when you were younger?
Apart from schools, I would definitely say work ethic, because I think my work ethic at the time wasn't great. And I also want to change my subjects. And I also wish I had a mentor when I was in sixth form, because I wasn't too sure what to do at university and after. So thinking about how to make the most of your time at university is something I wish I could.
Even younger, who was your inspiration?
think I had my doubts even when I was at university, because I thought this is very different to what I expected. However, I am glad that I went in the long run. If I was to do anything differently, and that's really if I had like the means to, I would have maybe gap year and travelled. I did my gap year, I'd say, after LSC, when I was founding my company, I was working part-time, so I could set it up, and I was also travelling at that time, and I wish I did that one off earlier. I think travelling definitely makes you a well-rounded person. I'm not just trying to encourage you to get a passport. I just really enjoyed the time of travelling and experiencing new cultures. You learn so much from other cultures rather than being in the same place with the same, like being in the same place all the time.
Thank you for asking.
During your GCSEs, what do you think are like the best ways of revising? Apart from transfer.
So in that pack there's some revision tips, so definitely read them. There's four revision tips that I always say that I think about. I think about links, who I revise with. I think about logistics, how I use to revise. I think about location, where I revise. I can't revise in my house, my mum will always be talking to me. And I always think about logistics, links, location. And the other one is talking about how to revise in regards to like revision cards, past papers, examination reports, or do you prefer watching YouTube or listening to a podcast? There's so many different ways to revise. We don't really look to see how to do that. Thank you for asking. Okay. So I feel like I took a gap year when I finished. I worked in about three or four different industries. Out of all the industries I worked in, I told you I interned at a consultancy firm for 3 months. I absolutely loved it. I felt like it linked to my master's degree. I was allowed to think creatively about problems that were going on in society. I was coming up with solutions, I was coming up with workshops, and I was putting in all the different ideas that I'd learned over time and applying it to society. And I think consultants are really lucky that they get to work on a load of different projects within a varied time frame. So that's what we have.
Thank you.
What do you think I can do about social?
Apart from all the reading, I just like the way that there's different thinkers in the world. There's no one set answer. So in maths, 2 + 2 = 4. But in sociology, 1 + 3 = 4, 0 + 4 = 4. Different people think in different ways, and that basically comes to go into how we see society. Diversity, of course, is so important, and it's important to learn from that. Thank you. How am I doing for time? Are they okay?
Maybe 2 or 3 more questions?
Yes, 2 or 3 more questions. So,
yeah, you choose those main subjects.
So, when I picked my A-level subjects, I wanted to pick 2 writing subjects, and I wanted to pick 2 mathematics subjects, so 2 qualitative and 2 quantitative. So my quantitative subjects were economics and maths, and then I picked qualitative, which was sociology and religious studies. So I kind of decided between the 2 of them, especially because my teacher at Regional advised me to do sociology, and I hadn't done it before. So I was thinking, why is he advising me to study this? But it's only when I took the subject, I understood that he knew me very well, and I've gone on to study it for 7 years, so he was onto something when he said it. So that's how I decided.
Yeah,
yourself? Yeah,
thank you. Hi,
Dick. I think it's really, you're in a really privileged stage because you're all here in the same talk at the same time, and your friends will understand like this is the time to study and this is your time to go out. So you need people who have a similar mindset or a similar work ethic to you. But it's also using maybe social time to study as well. So hey, do you want to study together? That's better than saying let's not meet up at all. I think friendships are important. You need to cultivate it in a time where you're going to be very stressed and you might be wondering how to revise better. So if you can balance the 2 by maybe putting some of the commitments together, it will help. And my last question, if you've got a pack already for another reason, please put it down on your hand.